It's the Andy Snowden Radio Show. 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 So, what is going on around town? What can you go and see tonight, Andy? I hear you chow. Well, over in Chester, the Storyhouse Theatre is now celebrating its second birthday already. I can't believe it. And they are celebrating with the perennial cult favourite sci-fi musical, The Little Shop of Horrors. Following the story of a floral assistant, Seymour Krellborn, who stumbles across a new breed of carnivorous plant that promises to grant him fame, fortune, and all he desires as long as the blood keeps flowing. Little Shop of Horrors is the latest show to be produced by the Storyhouse Theatre and will feature the creative talent of the Olivier Award-winning director and choreographer, Mr. Stephen Mear. That's a catch. So on Tuesday afternoon, I caught a word with West End star Mr. Joshua Lay, who is taking the lead role of Seymour Krellborn at the Storyhouse in Chester in this Little Shop of Horrors. Here he is on the Stage and Screen Show telling you all you need to know. Joshua Lay. Is this your first time to the Chester Storyhouse, then?
Yeah, my first time ever. I've never even visited before. It's an amazing space. It's such an incredible place as a theatre, cinema, library, sort of like community hub. It's brilliant.
And it's commemorating its second birthday, which is exactly why you're there.
Oh, yeah, no, we're doing Little Shop of Horrors for their second birthday. I think last year they did Little Night Music, and this is sort of celebrating the second birthday.
And I mean, here's the thing, right, for me. I think Little Shop of Horrors is possibly, well, it's got to be one of the best musicals that I've ever seen in my life. And you're playing one of the best characters in it. You're playing the part of Seymour, right?
Yeah, I'm playing Seymour. It's such a great show, isn't it? It's so well written, and the music's brilliant, the script is hilarious, and I can see why it's such a big cult classic. And the film's amazing as well. I love the film.
Yeah.
The musical just doesn't have any sort of, I think our director said that they've trimmed all the fat off it. There's nothing, everything in it sort of pops.
Yes, absolutely. And I think it's a bizarre one because it's probably one of the only musicals that I can think of where if someone was to say to me, which is your favourite song, I couldn't think of one because there's so many good songs in it.
Yeah, there's such great music. It's Alan Menken who does a lot of the Disney stuff.
Yeah.
But it's sort of like an adult comedy. It's suitable for, it's not just for adults, but it's got such an adult sense of humour. But mixed in with the music of Alan Menken and the lyrics of Howard Ashman, it's brilliant writing. If you want a rationale, it isn't very hard to see. No, stop and think, it'll overpower. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. He's so nasty, treating her rough, smacking her around and always talking so tough. You need blood and he's got more than enough. Could you give us a quick synopsis for those two or three people who's never seen it? Yes, sure. It's set in late 50s in downtown New York in a place called Skid Row. It's sort of based around a florist on Skid Row that isn't doing very well. And one day, one of the clerks who works there, my character Seymour, he comes across an unusual plant, because that's his hobby, finding unusual plants. He finds this unusual plant that sort of changes everything, and people start becoming interested in the shop, people start becoming interested in the plant, and it sort of brings about a lot of good fortune for Seymour and for everyone involved in the shop. He's in love with one of the other clerks who works at the florist called Audrey,
And then he's got his boss, who adopted him, Mr. Mushnik. And everything starts to change, but the plant starts developing a taste for blood. Uh-huh. And that's the only thing that will make it grow. So he starts to have to make a deal with the plant to sort of keep feeding it. So it sort of grows and grows from there. It's kind of like Faust-like. It's sort of, you sort of have to make promises for great fortune with the cost of, I don't know, a bit of crime.
It really is. I mean, it's such an out there story, isn't it? That it somehow works. It's a bizarre one.
Yeah, it's very zany, but it's got a lot of heart to it. There's a real, he's sort of doing it for love, everything he's doing, and so it's there is a real sort of like beating heart at the centre of it, but it's quite wild otherwise.
And here's another amazing fact for you. I had Amanda Whittington on my show a couple of weeks ago.
For brilliant.
those of you who don't know her, she's a writer, of course, and she did the Kiss Me Quick Step, which not only yourself, but Michelle Bishop, who's playing Audrey's, was in it as well.
We just finished playing opposite each other, me and Michelle, in Kiss Me Quick Step. And then, now we're, during that show, we were auditioning for, we were both auditioning for Little Shop of Horrors, and we both got it, which was really nice. We sort of just carried on together,
yeah,
playing very different roles.
Because, I mean, I came to see it. I took my daughter to see it in Theatre Clwyd. And I've got to tell you, mate, that is one big ask for any performer, what the parts that you guys played in that. I mean, incredible.
Yeah, it was a really brilliant play. We had such a great time doing it. Very, very different to what we're doing now. So it's really nice to sort of... we were mainly dancing and acting. We were mainly acting with a bit of dancing in Kiss Me Quick Step. And this is all singing and acting in this one.
Yeah.
It's really nice.
Could you do ballroom dancing beforehand? Because you all looked, like, so efficient at it all. It was incredible.
Oh, we had to learn quite quick. Some of us hadn't. I hadn't. I hadn't really done any ballroom. I think Michelle had just done Strictly Ballroom in London, the musical, and we had one of the characters, Adrian. He was a ballroom dancer when he was younger, and so he sort of like whipped us into shape, ready for the show.
Yeah.
It was great fun.
It was. I mean, it blew me away, actually. I mean, my auntie and uncle actually did Come Dancing in the 70s. They were actually in that original kind of thing. And I texted them in the interval. I said, you've got to come and see this thing. It's brilliant. It really was.
Great.
But I'm looking, of course, on your CV. I mean, you've done so many things, so many great things in musical theatre, including working with my brother, of course.
Yeah, I've worked with your brother. Had a great time. We did Crazy Few together in London quite a while ago. I think it was about 8 years ago, I think.
So did you train as an actor or a dancer or what?
I trained in musical theatre. So I originally, when I was a kid, I really wanted to be an actor. And then I did a musical, and the people at the dance school said, oh, he can dance. So I started dancing. And then I sort of thought, well, if I enjoyed dancing and acting, I should really learn to sing. So I started quite young, when I was about 12, trying to cover all the bases. And then so I had my dance and dance drama and sort of everything training in Woking when I was a kid. Then I went to the Brit School, did a musical theatre course for 4 years. Then I went to Arts Ed for 3 years to do another musical theatre degree course. So it was an all-round kind of musical theatre training.
But one of the things that does stand out to me is the X Factor, and I know my listeners would want to know. They look like they work you hard on that.
I wasn't a contestant. I didn't have to go through all that.
Is it 2018 you did it, yeah?
Yeah, I did it in the final, just danced in the show.
Right, okay. All right, brilliant.
It was just a one-day gig. It's just funny.
I often look at it and just go, the dancers are working the hardest in this show.
Yeah, no, it was a... I just did a little brief thing, but it was fun.
It looks good on the CV, I suppose.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, Joshua, man, it's been a pleasure speaking to you. Thanks ever so much for that.
Thank you. It's been great.
Yeah, lovely. And well, hopefully, I'll get over to Chester. And you're only on till the beginning of June, aren't you?
Yeah, we run till June 2nd.
Cheers, buddy. You take care of yourself.
Thank you. Yeah, take care. Cheers.
Thanks, man. Take care.
Very
bye.
Much. Bye. Okay, bye. Bye.
So there you go, the Little Shop of Horrors running at the Storyhouse Theatre in Chester. Now, it's running now until the 2nd of June. And Joshua Lay, starring as Seymour Krelborn. For tickets, 01244 409 113. That's 01244 409 113. Or you can book online, just www.storyhouse.com/Little Shop of Horrors. Go on, support your local theatres, ladies and gentlemen. They won't be there forever if you don't. This is the Stage and Screen Show, ladies and gentlemen, and you are more than welcome to it. Leading us up to the news, a little bit of electro violet. Velvet, I should say. Electro velvet, there it is. I can't speak. I don't know what's going on with me. Anyone would think it was Eurovision night.